Hey guys, welcome back. It is Marksman here, and I am bringing another game, or another series game, I should say, of In the Mind of a Search and Destroy player due to request. Really quick, before I talk about what we're going to do, this is an entire game, and it's an extended series of the video. I mean, usually I just do one round, but this game, I feel like I can talk about something that I have not shown, and I think I should. This is actually a game from the stream. I invite people in from the stream and played with them, and it actually worked out pretty well. So you're going to notice, first off, that me and Haas, we work really well together. We're going to go up to Patio. You'll see me using an M14, a gun I rarely ever use. I just do not like it at all. And you use Haas having an MSR with a sniper. You look like a ninja. That is scary shit. And you have these other three people going down toward street. Now, he is using a USAS, I believe. Okay, how did I go through the wall and not go back through it? USAS, MP7, and what is this? ACR of some kind. It looks like a rifle. Now, it's important to note that if you're going to go street, you're going to want a long-range weapon. Me and Haas, we have weapons that could do well on street, but the way we're going to play Patio, it works out fine. All right, so we're going to run over to Patio here. And first thing you're going to notice is Haas. He instantly will throw a stun there, and his goal is to stun him right off of the spawn. I throw one too off to the right, because usually when people walk out, they'll walk out right, or when they walk out the store, they'll walk out to their left first, because it's the first open availability they can get to. So that will stun him and that guy, but there's a lot right now pushing Patio. And I know when they start throwing stuff that we're not able to push up right away. So Haas gets a nade kill, which is great. Gives us the chance to move up. Now we don't want to run down the stairs right here. We're not using submachine guns like I talked about. So you're seeing us sit back further. Haas snipes one, and this is a really good spot to pick up people that will be on the head glitch. If you stand on top of those boxes, you can pick them up right here. Now, I know that someone could be right in the corner there, because people camp there very often. So I find him, kill him. This might be longer than I'd like, but yeah, it helps a lot. Now, me and Haas, our job is simple here. I want to make sure I point this out. We are supposed to be holding Patio. That's our job. If they can't push Patio, they can't get around us because our other teammates went to street and they weren't dead. So, whoa. Okay, there we go. So almost the same strategy. They're going to go street and make sure they can't push through street and go middle to make sure they can't go through middle. We're going to go to Patio and make sure they don't flank from our spawn and so they don't come up top on like the top stairs and shoot at them. This time I get in the same spot to cover the alleyway there. Covered the same corner there before, just because some people will go back to that corner even after you shot them there before. Now you're going to see me get on this corner right here. This is a great spot to take out people that walk out of A, and at the same time you can see all the way down this alley. And this is an important thing because a lot of guys will be sitting right here trying to head glitch this trash thing, yeah, or back behind this car or into this thing or in this corner. Like, yeah, I didn't even know that guy was there, but he is. Regardless, I chill right here because they're going to arm the bomb, and I'm going to be able to cover this entire alleyway, which is an important thing. I mean, it's if I can cover this entire way, that means my teammates only have to look towards street. That's a pretty easy thing for four people to do over there, three people. So I'm just sitting right here. When I shoot an unsilenced weapon, get the hell out of the way. Don't stay in the same spot, because if you shoot a weapon, an unsilenced weapon, I should say, and people hear it, they instantly will try to run at you and attack you. This isn't it's going to happen about 98% of the time, I'd say. This isn't due to because of you firing the weapon and killing someone. It's due to the fact that you pop up on radar or on the mini UAV or whatever the hell that is, mini map. Thank you. There we go. and when someone can see someone on a mini map, you want to take advantage of that, and they'll try to rush you to get the kill before your red dot disappears. I do the same stuff. I'm really careful about it, but I also know people do the same thing, so I predict them. So that's why I move out of the way and I go to the other side. All right, then I heard my teammate die on street. Another teammate died on street. He went that way, so I decided to go middle to help out in middle. In the middle, you can head glitch the bomb right there behind me on that box, or you'll see me go to the next place, which is a little further up, to be honest, but at the same time, it works really well as right here. My teammate said he has street covered, so I turned around to try to cover under him just in case. Then he got taken out. I unfortunately could not find the guy. He just kept disappearing. But I keep him off the bomb, which is the point, right? And I do end up getting him here at the end. This is going to be much longer than I'd like. I don't want to do this, but I will, because I don't want to stop mid-game. That seems bad. Another similar strategy. We're going to run up there. Haas is going to leave me alone this time. He's got a sniper, so he's going to cover Street with our team. He's practiced Street. I really have always, almost always, have gone patio. In MLG or in game battles, whatever, and in pub matches. I'm just really good at covering patio. So I sit here. I know I don't want to walk out too far. I want to make sure I get him off the end of that box. So you see I'm not overextending. I'm pretty much playing patio the whole time, making sure they can't get up there. This is due to like the whole team effort. I mean, when my teammates cover the other side of the map, this is one of those maps where if you can push on all three portions, which is the street, the middle, and patio, you can lock the other team out completely. And it's really hard for the other team to make a push. So you want to make sure you be aggressive on this map, because otherwise you're going to get locked out and it's going to be very difficult for you to make a move. So even if this dude was go head glitch right there, I would have picked him up from the top of my boxes. My head glitch is a little better. So that ends round three. Now you're going to see round four. I'm gonna explain again here really quick. Back up. See us run. So you have Lego and Haas going that way. I'm going up to patio with Empathy. This guy's not on our squad. He's camping in the spawn. He's bad. And Hero is calling something in. So Haas, again, what is he using? MSR. I wouldn't suggest going this way with an MSR, but I don't think he's going to push too far in the middle. I think he's just going to go to this door and look down the alley here. He's going street. I'm hoping he has a long-range weapon. MP7, that's fine. I can go anywhere, to be honest. PP90, close range. And my M14, which is decently good at close range. But it depends how you use the weapon in which situation. So Haas, he does look in the middle, but realizes no one's there, so he pushes in. Now I go patio, and I'm going to sit here on this head glitch and make sure they can't walk up on patio. This is just to keep him away. Someone called a predator and called him in their spawn, so I called a predator in to get him. I picked up one in their spawn. Now right there, we had two people go down. JMoney1245 killed Empathy and Haas right in front of me here. You saw the little X's right there. Thank God Haas is sitting next to me. He called him out, and he said the guy was hiding behind bricks, which is right here. So I wasn't going to push up, but I do know the angle at which I need to throw a nade. So I throw the nade just over the top of it, take him out, and I push into middle. I push into middle for two reasons. One, I want to check the bomb. And two, because I have a teammate already on patio. So if I go middle, then I can lock him off from going middle too. And I have a teammate in their spawn that pushed from street. So that means we've covered street. We have one person pushing patio. I'm going middle. So if you actually look at the setup from right here, he's looked around this area. I've looked around this area, and I don't see anyone. And this guy's pushed up here and looked around. And he hasn't been killed yet. So that means he has to be within the area in between us. I mean, it's kind of common sense, but I just want to point it out that that's kind of why I go middle and I wanted to lock it out. So yeah, he could be anywhere back here, anywhere in these buildings, but he has to be in between us three people. So you want to maintain like concave? Not a concave, is it? Yeah, I think it's a concave, and you want to keep him inside it. It's almost, I'm trying to find a good analogy for it. If you take a fishing net and you put it onto the ground flat and pretend that the outer rim of the fishing net is your team, that means the player can only be with inside the net. But he can be anywhere in that area inside the net, if that makes sense. So I'm going to chill here and cover middle as my teammates roam around. I heard him fire a silenced weapon right over this grass. So I just have fun for the last kill and take him out. And that ends the game, guys. It's a little longer than I would have hoped, but it is a full game, so I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I gave you a little better insight to how to play whatever the hell map this is. And at the same time, I hope I don't know, you're enjoying the series. Leave a comment, rate, or subscribe. I'd appreciate it. And make sure to keep on gaming, guys.